Hello everyone, welcome to another Death Stranding news update. Haven't done one of these in a while, but then again, information on this game is rather scarce. So what can I do? But to make up for lost time, in today's video we'll be talking about potentially big information. Those who've been following Death Stranding since its announcement will know that one of the things that's been eluding us these past few years is the actress who will play the game's female protagonist. We know Norman Reedus will be playing the main protagonist, Sam, we know Mads Mikkelsen will be playing the main antagonist, and we know Guillermo del Toro's likeness will be a prominent character. But besides Kojima telling us that he's looking for someone to play the female lead, we don't know anything about the character or who Kojima has in mind. There have been rumors that we might see Stephanie Houston work with Kojima again, or that Kojima might hire the likes of Emma Stone based on his infatuation with La La Land, but nothing is certain. However, recent developments and discoveries indicate that Kojima may have already found the actress who will be playing the female lead, and that she might be none other than Diane Kruger. Before we dive into all the evidence pointing to this, let's talk a bit about who Diane Kruger is. She's actually quite a prolific actress, and you may best know her from films like Troy, the National Treasure series, and Inglourious Basterds, among many other films. Interesting to note is that she was born in Germany and later moved to Paris to learn French before she made her debut in films. I bring this up because there are elements of both France and Germany in Death Stranding's second trailer. This particular setting is almost certainly France, judging by the unique electrical poles, and we do hear elements of German being spoken at one point. Assuming that she is involved, not sure if her nationality and multilingual facets would somehow tie into the game's multinational influence, but just something worth noting. Moving on, let's talk about evidence linking Diane Kruger to Kojima's upcoming new game. I'd like to begin by directing you to a tweet that Kojima posted back in December 4th, 2016, which said, quote, "I finally got to meet an actress who I've been in love with for over 10 years. Now, at the time, Emma Stone was a fairly popular rumor, and while she did technically debut in TV and films in 2005, which is over 10 years prior to Kojima's tweet, she didn't really play any prolific roles up until she starred in Easy A, a movie from 2010, which is only 6 years prior to Kojima's tweet. So it's hard to think that this actress Kojima's been in love with for over 10 years is Emma Stone. Now, if we take a look at Diane Kruger's film history, you'll see that she's been doing films since as far back as 2001, and arguably her most prolific role in the early days was Helen of Sparta in the movie Troy, which came out in 2004, which is definitely over 10 years prior to Kojima's December 2016 tweet. With all said and done, it is more likely that Kojima was referring to Diane Kruger rather than Emma Stone in this tweet. Now, you may be wondering, Young, there are plenty of actresses who have been in the film industry long enough to fit Kojima's description. What makes you think it's Diane Kruger specifically? Well, let's start with the fact that back in February 2018, Kojima and his assistant Ayako were spotted hanging out with both Norman Reedus and none other than Diane Kruger. Now, it is worth noting that Norman and Diane are dating, so this could very well have been Norman inviting his girlfriend to dine with a few of his work associates and friends, so this picture by itself isn't much confirmation of anything. But then we start looking at more recent developments, like how 2 days ago, Kojima's assistant Ayako posted a picture showing Diane Kruger receiving Kojima Productions merchandise as a gift, alongside Fatih Akin, director of her new film In the Fade, as well as a picture of Kojima, Diane, and Fatih hanging out, and how Diane herself posted a picture on her Instagram page of Kojima and Fatih, calling them both legends, as if she's worked with both. It would seem as though Kojima's been hanging out with Diane quite a bit more often than mere association with Norman Reedus would warrant, wouldn't you say? One would almost assume that Kojima and Diane are working together over at Kojima Productions, perhaps on a little game we know as Death Stranding. But as if all that wasn't enough, there is one last bit of definitive evidence that will put the nail in the coffin, and that evidence is this Instagram image that Diane Kruger posted on September 29th, 2017. It is a picture of her hand wearing motion capture gloves, and the message that she posted alongside it simply reads, "Mocap weirdness." That's right, folks. Over the past few months, Diane Kruger has been involved in some project involving motion capture. And with her recent associations with Kojima Productions, the only assumption I can make is that this is for none other than Death Stranding. For the cherry on top, I would like to direct your attention to the mocap gloves themselves. If you compare it to what Norman Reedus is wearing during his Death Stranding mocap sessions, you'll notice that they are identical. They've got the same gray color, the same X-shaped stickers with little balls on top, and the same band-aid-like rings with small balls on top being worn on the pinky and index finger. So yeah, at this point there is almost no doubt in my mind that Diane Kruger is in fact involved in Death Stranding alongside Norman Reedus and Mads Mikkelsen, and considering she's a high-profile actress, it's almost certain that she was cast as the game's lead female character. I should also note that she does bear a significant resemblance to the recent artwork of a female Ludens that Kojima posted in celebration of the 2018 New Year, particularly where the hairstyle and hair color are concerned. And we all know that Kojima has teased actors with drawings and artwork in the past, so we can't rule this out as mere coincidence. So yeah, there you go, folks. All the evidence pointing to Diane Kruger almost certainly being involved in Death Stranding and very likely being the game's female protagonist. I'd love to hear what your take is on all of this in the comments below. With that, I would like to end this news update. Thank you for tuning in. If you enjoy my content, consider supporting me on Patreon. It is completely optional, but donating even as little as a dollar a month will go a long way in helping this channel grow. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out!